My goal is to add some value to all of you. Can you all really hear me? Or you prefer that?
No.
How many of you prefer mic? Only one person. At least give him a round of applause. I want to encourage that kind of a contrarian thinking. Okay, it's okay, I want to be yourself. I want you to feel free to raise your hand. Can you all raise your hand? Okay? And stand up. My most important point that I'm going to make to you all today is really promoting entrepreneurial thinking in various aspects of your life and how it can dramatically improve your life to achieve your own goal, right? So I'm thinking there are three kinds of people in this room. After you graduate, some of you probably want to take up a job. Some of you probably want to do a startup of your own. Some of you want to go for higher education, okay? Let's see how many of you fall into each of these, okay? How many of you want to take up a job right after you graduate? Can we give them a round of applause? How many of you want to do a startup of your own after you graduate? Wow, we have a few. Wow, give them a round of applause also. How many of you want to go for higher education after this? Is that the majority? Okay, give them a round of applause also. How many of you don't want to do anything after you graduate? Wow, yeah. Give them a round of applause. Seriously, raise your hand one more time. What do you want to do after you graduate? Not sure. Not sure. How about you? Nothing. Take your vacation. 4 years is so tiring. Who else raised your hand for the last one? Okay?
Relax.
Have a charminar, right? Or go relax. Travel. Okay. I didn't expect the last category. Yeah, I wish I could have done that. So I'm going to talk to you about a few things, right? And I'm good at telling stories. So I was all these institutions that I went to. When you say institution, doesn't that sound like a mental institution sometimes? All these great institutes that I went to, I'm so grateful because they educated me, they empowered me and all of that. I was really good on the technology side, but I was supremely shy, you know. I couldn't do this. I couldn't talk in front of people. You know, if you ask me to put down all my fears, I was more afraid of public speaking than of dying, which means I would rather die than talk to you. Isn't that crazy? And that is one of the most important things that entrepreneurship helped me overcome, is a lot of fear. How many of you have seen little babies? Right? Maybe you have a niece or a nephew or a neighbor's kid or something, 1 year old. What do the parents have to do with a little baby? Complete ownership? Yes. How many of you would say you take complete ownership? This was the difference. I started working in Accenture. I was in a box in a cubicle and I could do my job and I could go home. It didn't matter to me. I had to just do my little piece. It didn't matter to me if the company made profits or not. Are you all understanding? Because I was doing the small piece. But the small piece did not make the company. On the other hand, when I started a business, however small, mine was, the first business was extremely small. It's microscopic. Didn't matter, but it was my baby. So what did I have to do for the baby? Can you all say everything?
Everything.
That, exactly like a baby. You have to do everything, totally helpless. And when you have to take care of that baby, you suddenly start doing things that you never did for yourself. How many of you agree with what I'm saying? So entrepreneurship started bringing me out. There were things I could not do when I did my startup. Maybe I did not know programming. Maybe I did not know how to do sales. Maybe I did not know how to do marketing. That means I have to suddenly start convincing other people to join me and help me, yes? Which means I have to be good at what?
Communication.
Communication? What else?
Networking.
Networking? What else?
Persuasion.
Persuasion, yes. What else? Also called selling, right? Many of us don't like the word. How many of you don't like the word selling? Raise your hand. Okay, two of you. Remaining are also afraid of selling, but they don't want to raise their hands for that. It's okay to laugh. Okay. So, that's where I was, and my first startup, let me talk a little bit about how I became an entrepreneur, right? And for some reason, I went into the cubicle of my job, and this feeling dawned on me. I haven't been in this cubicle for the next 40 years. And that felt more like a prison to me than a job. Okay? And that was the day I realized I'm not meant to be in a cubicle. I needed to be free. I said, if I need to control my own time and my own money, I need to be an entrepreneur. Right? So that was the thing that got me started in thinking, oh my God, I need to do something on my own. Right? And I know your students, you haven't even experienced enough. So that is the first thing, is I had not had enough experience. Right? Until I finished my bachelor's, master's and PhD, I never walked into a job. I did not do any internships. So my first job experience was at Accenture when I walked in on day one. Great job, six-figure income, every reason to be excited. Right? How many of you would be excited if you made $100,000 per year in income? Right? Would that be cool? I should have been doing backward somersaults. On the other hand, I came back. At the end of day one, I'm depressed. And my wife looks at me and saying, you worked hard, you did your PhD, and after a few months you got this job. Why are you depressed? This is bizarre. And she was baffled, right? And here I am saying, you don't understand, it's a cubicle, I have to be there until I'm 65. Okay? If you feel like that, probably you have an entrepreneur hiding inside of you. But you don't have to be. I'm just saying, the thing that hit me hard was, I was climbing very fast on this ladder. Bachelor's, master's, PhD. How many of you were impressed by the educational institutions I went to? Right? There was a time even I was impressed. Till I realized, I reached the end of my PhD and then I look around and say, wrong wall. How many of you would like to climb a ladder for 10 years and realize it was on the wrong wall? How many of you would be really upset with something or somebody? I said, I want my money back. I didn't know from whom. So that was my challenge. So why did that happen? Can anybody tell me, why did I climb this ladder for 10 years? To realize that I was leaning against the wrong wall. And can anybody tell me why that happened? It's an important question because it could happen to you.
Parents.
Sorry?
Parents.
Parents. What did my poor parents do? Okay, definitely not my parents, okay? But your clothes, can you modify it? He's close. He immediately went from parents to relatives. Until I need to meet your family. He's close. It was not my parents. It's what I thought my parents wanted me to do. Shall I say that again? It was not my parents, because my parents never sat me down and said, we want you to do a PhD. It was what I thought my parents wanted me to do. Are you all understanding this? It's very important. If you're taking notes, write that sentence down. Otherwise, just write on the back of this shirt. And after this class, take this shirt off. You're all relaxed now. That's the main thing. So, for me, that was kind of important. It was a realization that, oh my God, I was so conditioned by the environment. I grew up in Indian Institute of Science. My dad is now a retired professor there. What do you think I was hanging around? What was the minimum degree of the people around me? PhD. So I thought if I did not get a PhD, I would not be allowed to live on campus or in the house. So that's the second lesson for you guys. Your environment shapes you, whether you like it or not. What is that? Your environment shapes you, whether you like it or not. The question is it shaping you to become what you want to become or what somebody else wants to become? In my case, I was being shaped by default into being somebody that nobody wanted me to be. 10 years. I hope you're all realizing this. That's why, as simple as this choice of three, all of you raise your hand so confidently. You should not be that confident at your age. But honestly, you should all be thinking, half of you should all be like this. Or like this. Or like this. You know? Some people said, did you say I don't know? Who said I don't know? Please stand up. There should be a lot of I don't knows. Give him a round of applause. At least he has not conditioned himself to follow the crowd. How many of you have seen the movie Three Idiots? Do you know who the fourth one is? Sitting in your seat. Was certainly sitting in my seat. Okay? I think the same thing as the movie says. And why did that happen? I was conditioned by my environment. I was conditioned. I was thinking somebody else expected me to do something. So conditioning of the environment. You want to be really super careful about your environment. I did not know, and this is important for you guys, I did not know I could design my environment to become what I wanted to become. I did not know that I could design the environment to become what I wanted to become. Can somebody here that knows exactly what you want, really has a passion, raise your hand that you know what you want to become 5-10 years from now? Can you raise your hand? There's one person. Okay, what would you like to be 5-10 years from now?
A good professor.
You would like to be a professor? What's your name?
Aditya.
Now, if I were Aditya, I would start nailing that down. Professor. Think of the world as a GPS. How many of you know what a GPS is? What do you need to give the GPS for you to bring that to this world? What kind of location? Bangalore. Will it bring me here? Or India? Will it bring me here? How about Bangalore? Will that bring me here? So what should I give, Aditya? What address should I give the GPS to come here? More precise.
Coordinates.
More precise. Coordinates means what? Exact. Am I right? I was not able to give an exact destination. That's why I was climbing against the wrong wall for 10 years. That is my next question to you guys. Why was I not able to give an exact destination like he did? I'm not talking to the teachers here, but the rest of you, how many of you are over 30 years of age? 25? No. Which means what? You have not even lived a quarter of your life. Yes? That's like going to a buffet which has 100 items and you have tasted 25. And if I asked you what's the best item in the buffet, what will you say? You haven't tasted all of it. Are you all understanding? This is the biggest challenge that we have, especially when we are growing in a conditioned environment, is we are not allowing ourselves to give ourselves enough experiences. You know the last question I asked? How many of you don't know what you want to do? Please raise your hand one more time. Those of you that answered my last question there, you know, of the first three alternatives. And they all said what? They all said things that the rest of you thought they were crazy. Honestly, how many of you thought they were crazy? Raise your hands. We all thought they were crazy, right? Why did we think they were crazy? Vacation, relax. What, 4 years I'm studying to go somewhere? That guy's studying 4 years to relax. That's what we thought, right? But on the other hand, they were allowing themselves to give themselves experiences. They are kind of, in some sense, more self-aware. They're saying, you know, I don't seem to have experience enough to know what I like. Out of these 25 items, I don't like anything. I haven't tasted chicken biryani yet. It is the 60th item. How many of you like chicken biryani? See? How sad it would be till you are 60 years of age if you did not even taste chicken biryani. Would that be sad? How many of you would agree? Raise your hand if you think that would be the biggest tragedy of your life. That's exactly what is happening is you haven't allowed yourself to have those experiences. You are getting your experiences in your life so slowly because you're only on a track. You're like a sheep. I was like a sheep. I was going for 10 years like a sheep. You're not understanding? The view does not change because what is in front of me? No, the rear end of another sheep. If it was a sheep, it would have been okay. My view did not change one big butt. Look at me. I was not allowing myself to give me experiences. So allow yourself, go draw some picture. If everybody throws up, you're not good at it. I understand. You're singing, even mosquitoes fly away from you. Okay, you're probably not destined to be a singer. You're all agreeing with me? Right? You blow up a couple of labs in chemistry or something. I know you're a registered for chemical engineering, but you should get out of it as soon as you can. And your professors will thank you. They'll send you a thank you card. They'll write a strong recommendation letter for you to go into arts. What kind of experiences can you give yourself? Can you expand your thinking? You're all thinking, Kanth, you don't know, you're crazy. You just walk in here and you say, I have experiences. I only have assignments. I have exams. As soon as you get out of here, I have to study. I have to finish an exam. I have to finish an assignment. I have to study. Yes? But honestly, how many of you watch TV and don't mind admitting? How many of you spend a little bit of time on WhatsApp every day? Facebook? How many of you, there's no Netflix here, right? How many of you watch movies? That's a part-time job for you. What is the latest good movie in India? Martian. How many of you have seen Martian? How many of you have seen Martian more than once? You saw it more than once? It just came out. How many times did you see it?
Twice.
What was the big hit recently? Bahubali?
Bahubali.
How many of you have seen Bahubali more than once? More than twice. How many times, man? Four times? Have I proven to you, you have time to give yourself experiences? Not the same experience, same movie theater, same chair, same butt, same movie, different act, huh? Indian movie makers have figured out 3.5 million ways of making a romantic movie. Okay? Skip the next movie. Go take a walk in the park. Do a painting. Do some. Go do computer programming. I don't know. Create a website. Can you all come up right now with one experience you can give yourself in the next 7 days? Something you have not done before, but you can easily do. Start shouting out. Come on, people, help me here. We have very little time. Madam, how much time is left? We are on military time here. If you don't say it, I'm going to pick you. Not you.
Maybe sit and blossom the whole time. The second hand library. I was planning to do that.
You were planning to do what?
Sit in the bookstore,
second hand bookstore. Fantastic! Give him a round of applause. Great one. A late hand. One experience. Oh, you're not in the right. Can somebody push up? How many of anybody else here interested in adventure sports? Please raise your hands. Can I tell them and just take your hand? Another important point, write that down.